So here we go. Fan Zhengdong versus Liang Jingkun, the men's singles semi-final. So Fan Zhengdong, of course, has just taken the men's doubles title with Wang Chuqin. Therefore, he has spent over 5 hours on court.
Which is relatively low considering how much he's been on table one, or at least on court.
Yeah.
I think a big part of that is how flawless he's been in his record. He's given up very little, 3 hours 55, but Liang Jingkun not playing nearly as many events.
Yeah, less than 4 hours. Fantastic rallies. This is a taste of things to come. Fan Zhengdong wins it. Boy, some of those shots.
Yeah, we've already seen the feeling demonstrated here, the power out of reach. Look at this one. Hooking and a feeling shot there. Touch side spin. How does he play that so wide? There is no danger, he feels.
The crowd are certainly enjoying it. You can hear that already.
We are already now just 4 points in, and we've had a quality of point that is going to be very tough to top. Style matchup out here, mid-distance counter-looping rallies, the exchanges, the footwork from two of the most explosive in the world.
Just a little punchy type shot there from Fan Zhengdong.
Two.
Goes
four.
A little long there, Fan.
If your internet's good. I'm curious to hear their recent history. Oh, you as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, as in the head-to-head?
Yes. The specifics. I know 2019, Liang Jingkun, early on. It feels like the round of 32 off of memory. Just quite early on. Remember, Liang Jingkun took some time. A little timeout after a celebration.
That's a very nice way of putting it.
Well, it was. There are subcategories of the folder celebration if you zoom in a bit, but it definitely was a celebration.
Yeah, it was exuberant, shall we say. Pushed him wide.
Three.
To answer Adam's question, this is a repeat of the semifinals back in Houston, the last World Championships. Fan Zhengdong won that 4-1 that day. But they have met recently in Shenzhen, where you were at that event. Fan Zhengdong won that 4-1. He's won the last three, in fact. The last time Liang Jingkun won was at the World Champs, the famous one, where Fan Zhengdong lost in the round of 16.
Round of 16. Okay, last time they played, the first two games went extra points. 15-13 in the first.
Right.
And then deuce again in the second. Mm-hmm. 2 points. That's the difference needed. Clever idea here to play it down the line. Fan Zhengdong with a bit of a surprise in quotes, but Liang Jingkun not surprised by it. Watch him turn. That one has to finish the stroke with the racket to the left shoulder, Fan Zhengdong here. Just to try and surprise, hoping that Liang Jingkun would turn. Had he turned, it would have been an outright winner, but he didn't.
Got it.
Seven,
two ahead
five.
Here, Fan Zhengdong.
Good quality push there, some eye contact. Chole, many ask, what does it mean? There are a lot of guesses out there, but still no answers. No meaning for Chole.
8-5.
There are some derivatives. I know you've got some theories on it.
I've heard a lot of theories, of course, in Mandarin, Haoqiu, meaning good ball or nice shot. But that only explains part of it. So it's a, there are no complete answers. I haven't heard from any coaches, native Chinese speakers who've been in the game for decades. I haven't heard any sure answers.
5-9.
No, he just eases any kind of pressure that may be building here. Fan Zhengdong. Plays up beautifully down the line and sets up 5 game points here, Fan Zhengdong. Some great reactions, but not enough for Liang Jingkun. Yeah, the gasps in the crowd. You can understand why. The pace. Look at the way they're playing. Enjoyable to watch. Up here. You can hear the Fan Zhengdong fans.
Beautiful counter on the extension here. The reach from Liang Jingkun, and he plays it back wide. If he can stay a little bit closer to the table, he's close enough here to do it. Doesn't need much backswing there. Just able to lift the arm, counter back before the time is gone, the opportunity to exploit that wide forehand. Good start here, the first 3 points for Da Pang. Ooh!
Four,
and a gift to Liu.
Yeah, you don't see that too often.
Considering he only scored 5 points last game total, it's an attempted long serve here, Fan Zhengdong. First bounce has to be near his own baseline.
First point of the board then for Fan Zhengdong.
Remember their last encounter, Liang Jingkun went down 0-2. Didn't work out in his favor. Rarely does it. Fan Zhengdong pinning the middle, going right for that elbow from behind the table and at the first towel break here. He's won the last 2 points, the world number one, after a dominant first game, nearly getting his opponent in the thumb there, it appeared. Although, as we saw with Ma Long, hitting it off the hand, completely legal. Typically not intentional. Although there are some stories. It's exciting, actually. The question is, if it is legal, how can you use it to your advantage? Some pen holders at high levels would serve off their hand on the serve in crucial moments. If you can control it, it's going to be very tough to read on the other side. You're going to have virtually no sound. Who actually practices against balls off the hand?
That's tough, though, right?
Wow. It is.
Six, two.
Increases his lead to 4 here, Fan Zhengdong. Excuse me, Liang Jingkun increases his lead.
Six, three.
Wince there from Liang Jingkun.
Just grazing the net on the way over. Fan Zhengdong, a little bit of fortune in that low drive.
earlier, seven. I talked about similar numbers between Wang Chuqin and Liang Jingkun against Chinese players, less than 50% for both of them, and Fan Chengdong and Ma Long almost identical, 67% for Fan Chengdong against fellow Chinese players, his win percentage. From Liang Jingkun.
It's not easy to respond to a ball this fast, and there's a giant sweet spot on the forehand side for Liang Jingkun. Short stroke there, takes it early as he can, considering he's behind the table to counter to the open forehand side. A much needed point to get back in front the way he has been for the majority of this game. But remember, he's down 0-1 in games against the world number one. And maybe even more relevant, the fact that head-to-head, Fan Chengdong has won 80% of their 10 encounters. Yeah. It's no small sample pool. This is the dominant one on screen, world number one, Fan Chengdong. Just cleaning off the racket there to make sure that the rubber has full traction for spin and control.
Five, do you feel, nine. Adam, that with the result we saw in the previous semifinal, that cements Wang Chuqin is the second player to go to the Olympics, and Fan Chengdong is the number one?
I can't say cements.
Solidifies or consolidates his position.
Let's go. It wasn't a question of vocabulary. I understood your vocabulary is way better than mine, but I understood your question. I guess what I mean is there's no guarantee.
Of course.
First of all, he didn't beat one of the greatest threats to Team China. He beat China's role model and the greatest of all time. Mm. That's internal. Yes, it's on an international stage.
He moves to game point here, Liang Jingkun. He's got four of them.
These rallies here again, both players showing how flexible they can be. To cover the middle and the wide wings and still counter back aggressively with topspin makes you very well equipped at this level. Serves on his side to do it. Liang Jingkun looking to level the playing field.
One saved.
Seven.
So you're saying it's not necessarily all over for Ma Long either?
Yeah, that's
in
right.
In terms of the Olympics. Right.
He still has to be considered.
Because of the record against international players.
Correct.
Right. Well, Liang Jingkun has just taken the second game of Fan Chengdong.
Fiery first point here. Liang Jingkun looking to make quite a statement. Again, only 20% of his 10 encounters have gone his way against the world number one currently. Interesting, we see Fan Chengdong playing a little bit softer here, spinning in the rally, just sort of guiding, maybe trying to create his opportunity. A Hina Hayata-like tactic. But Liang Jingkun pulling out some Sun Ying Sha responses here.
Three, love.
Interesting, their Chinese nicknames, Da Pang for Liang Jingkun and Xiao Pang. That's Big Fatty and Little Fatty for the world number one, adoringly called by the fans in China.
Well, one of the fatties has just done very well here. Nice point.
Long push. He took it a little bit late, so realized trying to keep it short would probably not work to his advantage. He just says, might as well set myself up with a more predictable ball by pushing long first.
Good stuff from both of them. But it's Fan Chengdong who gets the point.
All the power that both of these guys have, I've bumped into Fan Zhendong before physically, and I can tell you he is rock solid. You might be able to tell that by looking at both of them.
You survived to tell the tale.
Hey, just barely. He let me live to come back and tell the village. I say that because I think about how delicate the touch is in the short game. And sometimes just getting the racket up when the ball has so much spin on it, blocking is more about control, but then all that strength needed when you take the initiative, when you get into the big counter-looping rallies, or when you're opening and trying to finish a point. Ripping backhand here. Fan Zhendong showing what he's made of and what the quads can do to help him twist into this ball. One, just holds firm, but pushes off a little bit with that leg, puts the elbow out, tucks the wrist back, and snaps through to unload.
Yeah, he's happier now. Some good moments here for Fan Zhendong.
The fight becomes very real. Before, it felt like, of course, they're playing with everything they've got, but it felt like they were feeling each other out a little bit. But there's eye contact. There's shouting. It's getting gritty. Bit of extra spin. As Liang Jingquan wraps around the ball, brushing up the back of it.
So this is many swings of momentum here. A couple of points here, a couple of points there. Tight, this one. Fan Zhendong just edging in front.
Taking that turn from the backhand corner. Fan Zhendong really getting comfortable now. Look at the momentum he's got. Six of the last 8 points. After Liang Jingquan won game number two, started off game number three here quite strong. Gotta love these rallies. As quick as can be, spraying it around, finds an escape. Puts it past Liang Jingquan on the wide forehand line.
Wonderful backhand here.
He's just constantly in squat position here. Fan Zhendong doing wall sits throughout this entire point.
This is going back and forth, isn't it, at the moment, this third game.
It's amazing to see how powerful these players can be when they really leave caution to the wind. Maybe even throw it, I guess. Sounds slightly less cautious.
Yep, returning the favor. Now Fan Zhendong.
Playing wisely to pin him in the middle there, spinning deep. Not a kill shot, just guiding it, thumb up on the back of the racket, putting it middle of the table, keeping the top spin on, adding a little bit as he goes.
Now pulling away, Fan Zhendong. Three clear of Liang. Feeling maybe a little bit more comfortable now than he might have been a short while ago. But we've seen how quickly it has shifted within this game alone. How
loaded
much spin
with
did he put on that?
Exactly, it was too much to handle. Not easy to shut down Fan Zhendong in this way. But Fan Zhendong looked ready to turn the corner, and Liang Jingquan spins it the opposite way, as low as can be. Finisher is the forehand in this rally. Backhand for days, and the forehand too fast. Sets up three game points for the world number one. Was trailing and came back to control. How low he gets there, the wide feet.
I thought for a second he may have clipped the net, but doesn't matter either way. Three game points for Fan Zhendong. Well, that'll be a nice one if he can mount the comeback, because this is brilliant. Look at this.
Cleans that one up. Just a little wiggle room there for a racket to swing past the back edge of the table, and that's enough for Liang Jingquan to secure the point here, saving a game point, but two more to go for Fan Zhendong. He'll be on the receive, though.
Mm. See, that was an important point there. The serve, the audacity.
Some really gutsy play, and then the placement here. So watch this, reverse pendulum. Where does he go with it? Right to the very corner, long and deep. And then he gets a ball to the shallow backhand side, spins it. Fan Zhendong has done some of the best side spin chops in modern history recently.
He set that up so well. Look at that, that's why he pumps his fist.
Well,
two crucial points.
Yeah, and he saved three in a row, three game points. Take a look at how he does it. Reverse pendulum once again. This is a serve that Fan Zhendong and Zhang Jike before him have really made iconic. But it's the touch play to follow the placement, and here we are at deuce. No, he did not. But yes, he did. He runs it down, extends it to the fingertips, and plays the short side of the table. Keep your eyes on Fan Zhendong on this one. Barely any backswing. Stays on his feet and comes back. If that's cross court, Liang Jingquan's there. That's that look. How did he get the best of me in that moment? Game point, fourth time over for Fan Zhendong. No, and he blocks it back. He counters it with topspin. If you asked people before this event started, who are your favorites to win it, I think there are two Chinese players who would have been forgotten, and Liang Jingquan was one of them.
Love one.
Who was the other one?
The Dark Knight.
Yeah.
Lin Gaoyuan.
Yeah.
These are the fourth and fifth representatives here for the men of China.
One, all.
Well, he has an opportunity to be remembered, Liang Jingquan. Can he come back again?
Remembered for something quite good. We shall see. Again, the biggest event of the year is this. I like the way they both sort of mirror that shot where they have to lift the elbow up just to get on top of the ball. The forehand to forehand exchange from the middle.
Attempt at the banana flick there, Liang Jingquan. Love that from Liang Jingquan.
It's always nice when you pick a spot on the table with confidence and someone's set up in the opposite position. Fan Zhendong had about 75% of the table covered with forehand, was already in position for it.
Four, two.
Shake of the head from Liang Jingquan.
Now, in case you're wondering why someone would set up a little bit early, Because I've talked about how important it is to have fast feet, reaction time, recovery time, agility, so that you don't have to leave early or anticipate. But as the point evolves, as you start playing, you play shots, you're constantly thinking, what's most likely to happen here? What can I expect to come back?
5-2.
Gritty indeed, there was the apology. I was wondering if we were going to see it because the long push clipped the net on the way over. Again, a big fight here. The biggest events, we saw it in 2019. Liu Shiwen bageling two opponents.
Yeah, and I wonder
six.
Whether Fan Zhongdong regards this as something a little unfinished, given the last time they met the world champs. He was eliminated by this very man, Yang Jingkun. Well, this is about as dominant as we've seen any game. Well, actually, I'll correct that. The first one was 11-5, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
This one is now a 5-point lead pretty early on. Can capitalize on that.
For me, I start to wonder, in preparation, Fan Zhendong has played the last three balls so decisively in the push game. He's come in really quickly to play it right off the bounce, and it just reminds me of Ma Long versus Fan Zhendong in 2017. Is he saying, go ahead and take the first attack? I can counter, I'll take advantage of you being slightly out of position, needing to recover. Well, he recovers well here. Yeah. Liang Jingkun takes the first forehand in the rally. It's countered back once, and he's there for another. There's the forehand, the first one, short stroke. And another short stroke back. This is a tactic. If you give the opponent the first forehand stroke, it's going to take them more time to recover. If you can short stroke, top spin it back, create an angle, something out of reach, wide to the forehand.
Nicely done there by Fan. After a couple of points from Liang Jingkun. Points clear, three needed. You can go 3-1 up.
I like that he goes all the way down to the laces for the contrast. It's important. If you're going to make a statement, make it clear.
5-8.
Off
six.
The serve, clips the net. Fan Zhendong just looks a bit annoyed with himself. Two in a row here for Liang Jingkun.
Very smart play. Fan Zhendong gets a defensive shot. Liang Jingkun, I hope he's okay. Ooh. Couldn't see him.
That was awkward.
Seemed like he slipped back and up for a minute. Let's take another look here.
Yeah, this would be a good view of it. Look at his right knee. Oh, that
his
one
left,
gets
out. His left foot slipped out from behind him. Put a lot of pressure on that right knee, you're right, but it's not the first time we've seen someone. And when you're expecting the traction that you need in that moment and you slide out, that can be really demanding on the body.
Keep an eye out for this. I wonder how much of that is playing in the mind as well as focusing what's on the table. 6-4 game points for Fan Zhendong.
There is a feeling of having to regather and regroup yourself after going down. Much like an ankle breaker in basketball, if you slip out here, the opponent's won the point that way, it can feel a little bit demoralizing.
Well, that'll help.
10.
Yeah, step in the right direction. Bit of success here for Liang Jingquan to save a game point. Fan Zhendong still with three left.
Went for the long serve.
Seven,
Fan Zhendong responds, and he takes.
Love one.
So he's got to win this match, this game, sorry, to stay in the match, Liang Jingquan. How's he going to go about doing that?
Two.
What have you liked about Liang Jingquan today?
What have I liked about him? Mm. Well, I think, first of all, he's been aggressive. I think he's been quite fearless. I think he's been thoughtful in terms of when to turn. I don't think he's pulled out quite too many surprises, though, in terms of the short game or the placement in his attacks. Much better here on the parallel. Steps around. He's good inside the table. I think he's going to have to trust that. That's going to take a bit of confidence to stay relaxed and stay loose. Short game. They're both strong in the open rally, but he's going to have to control in the short game, and so far, so good here.
There was an excellent start for Liang Jingquan. He's been pegged back a bit here.
Just amazing. If you think to yourself, what if Liang Jingquan hit that a little bit more to the elbow on that second backhand? Two in a row to the backhand. Fan Zhendong recognizing the pattern, snapping back. Had he hit it to the elbow, Fan Zhendong would have had to play a slightly more passive shot for angle.
That's whittled away, that quick lead that he had.
There we go, four, short side two. Of the table, a bit of misdirection. Again, two of the most powerful players in the world, but much like Hina Hayata, who will be referenced for a long time, you're not trying to beat someone at their game. You're trying to make them play your game, or at least take them away from their greatest weapons. Try to disassemble them. That's what Ma Long has done so well throughout his career.
5-2.
It's not always the most flashy shot that makes the difference in who wins the match. Not the most powerful, not the fastest. A good counter here on the reach. Fan Zhendong covering the wide forehand, bringing it back right at the baseline into the body. Good exchange rate here. Fan Zhendong, if he continues with this pattern, after being down 0-3. He'll get to 11 first here and move on to face Wang Chuqin.
Four, five.
Again, just a 1 point in it.
And he's got to take the timeout now. Oh, nice cover of the middle. Leaves it awkwardly on the table. Yeah. Right out of the timeout, Liang Jingquan. A bit of a survival mode point here. That racket heads straight up like an ice cream cone, brings it back, and it's a knuckling ball, just something a bit funky for Fan Zhendong to refoot himself for.
Seven, four.
Well, just when it looked that the pressure was right on Liang Jingquan, that timeout has helped so far.
How low he has to get. Waist way below the table. It's interesting, when you watch these guys stand before the serve, you can see how much higher than the table their waist is. But mid-rally, good flick here over the table. Fan Zhendong getting in with the forehand in the short game.
Two points in it.
Six.
does not look happy.
Every time Fan Zhendong comes within just a point of Liang Jingkun. I think that's the third time in this game. Liang finds just an extra gear.
Left, 8-6.
You could call this fight or flight mode. He has to find that gear now. Oh, back edge of the table here. Fan Zhendong blocks it and gets a bit of fortune. It's that 1 point distance you're talking about. Let's see if Liang Jingkun can take care of putting himself back in front by two.
Remember yesterday the edge that Fan got in the men's doubles?
Yes, I do.
Right towards the end.
Yes, yes, I do. New edge for edge. Well, now, what are the odds of that on the serve?
That's a couple of times he's done that, hasn't he? Clutch moments where he's done these long serves. Oh.
This is its own subcategory of long serve, though, and it sets up a 2-point lead. Fan Zhendong serving to try and tie it up.
1 point margin we talked about. What a time for him to do it now, if he can, Fan Zhendong.
The thing that I like is the more that the match matters, the better they play. Think about the semifinals at the Olympic Games. These are the semifinals here. Biggest event of the year.
Nice change on the angle there. Nicely done by Liang Jingkun, and he sets up 2 game points. He has not allowed Fan Zhendong to draw level with him at all in this game so far.
Going parallel there, playing out to the forehand with the backhand side. Setting it up, serves back on his racket here. Only needs to take one of them. Would much prefer the first.
Which he does. So, Liang Jingkun.
So Liang Jingkun starting off game number 6 with the serves. He saved it off the top of the net. Fan Zhendong gets it back somehow, not bothered by the rhythm break. And in the open counter loop exchange, the footwork is tested. Look at the placement on this shot, wider and wider, at least for a moment, and then back to the middle and sends him right back to where he came from. Don't get comfortable, not for a second.
That might well be the rally of the match so far.
22, love.
Remember, Fan Zhendong has been beaten at a World Championships. If you asked where was he, why was he not in the final in 2019? He was there in 2017. He took it in 2021. In 2019, Liang Jingkun was the reason Fan Zhendong was not in the final. Or at least in the quarterfinals, but it seemed likely that if he got through Liang Jingkun, he would have been the clash the world had been waiting for with Ma Long. Mattias Falk of Sweden would be the man. First in a long, long time, I think since 2003. But there wasn't a China-China final.
Nice done, the backhand there, opening himself up on the angle. Liang Jingkun draws level.
The banana flick around the side of the ball with topspin as well. And it's a low trajectory banana flick.
Two,
this one didn't work.
Yeah, the edge wasn't quite able to catch the ball.
How thoughtless of the edge. That was, I think, the third one he's tried like that.
Three,
That was a bit of an escape here. Liang Jingquan under some serious pressure in this rally. Fan Zhendong getting authoritative on the attack. Liang Jingquan with that very short stroke to cover the elbow. Fan Zhendong trying the short side, which means the net appears a little bit higher to block more of the table.
Part of that rally for Fan Zhendong.
It's impressive to me how often there are changes in the placement here. Right back into the body gets Fan Zhendong low, and he plays it back to the body twice in a row on that crossover point, causing a little pause in the setup for the backswing there of Liang Jingquan.
Left 4-3.
Just about made it over.
Four, all.
Yeah, and a little finger up from Liang Jingquan, an acknowledgement
of grazing the net on the last ball, but he definitely took his chances with this last backhand. The racket speed really tucks.
But he has to as well, doesn't he, Adam? Because this, again, the equation is the same here as it was in the previous game. He must win this.
That is true. Liang Jingquan down 2-3 in games. First to win four games wins the match.
Fan Zhendong still has that timeout in his, one. We saw that Liang Jingquan used it to good effect, ultimately, in the previous game. And the banana flick there himself, Fan Zhendong.
Yeah, a bit more spin on this ball, a bit more security as he puts the pressure on. He's had his fair share of attacks that were more drive-worthy, meaning more forward and less arc, a little bit less spin. But this wasn't one of them.
He went for the long serve himself there, Fan Zhendong.
It's a very bold attempt on the receive. Liang Jingquan looking to punish, almost as if to say, you can't fool me, and not only that, you can't serve long to me without dealing with a big shot. You saw him hit his head there in the replay. Maybe not the replay, but the moment after. I think he wasn't too satisfied with his shot selection.
Big shot there from Fan Zhendong.
It's so not only admirable, but almost unthinkable about how fast these players can move to play one shot powerfully and then start moving to prepare for the next. Watch this, turns, springs back up. He gets so low, Fan Zhendong there, still pins the middle, and is right back, just sailing through there, floating through the screen for that forehand should it come down.
A long push there.
Now this is something that Liang Jingquan doesn't want to have to worry about, Fan Zhendong being so confident that he can touch it softly in a moment like this. Watch, it was the last push shot that kept Liang Jingquan sort of coming back in a moment late. Not a lot of option after that clever touch play.
Eight.
Back edge of the Ooh. Table, Liang Jingquan.
Yeah, because that would have been 5-9. It was so difficult from there, but he's got it.
Time out.
World Championship final. See, the long serve is really coming into vogue in this match.
I was just thinking about it, long serve to the backhand and he pulls it out. If you're confident in the rally, as long as you can make the placement surprising, a long serve if it's fast enough, can get a more passive shot back, and then you're in a good position to predict where it will come. 2 points away from a spot in the final. But not so fast. Liang Jingquan still fighting point for point.
There are the Chinese players high up, looking down.
I see Lin Shidong, I see Wang Manyu, I see the team doctor, I see Wang Hao watching on, Qin Zhijian in the middle, Liu Hung, coaching staff.
Seven,
now,
ten.
We can talk about game points, not only that, match points. Three of them.
The way he springs up to his feet after taking shots like that from the middle. Fan Zhendong looking to not only be in good position on the scoreboard, but to be well prepared for the open rally. Serve, second time here with Liang Jingquan. He's saved his share of game points before, but match points, different story.
Gets past Fan Zhendong, and that's an acknowledgement there, isn't it? That expression.
Can understand here.
Just wrong-footed, perhaps, too far away.
Smart play, Fan Zhendong moving himself back in. He had a lot of ground to cover on the backhand court. Liang Jingquan had the wherewithal to hit it behind the momentum.
Go right back across him. Two match points, Fan Zhendong. Third men's singles final in four World Championships.